In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can move and revolve components in an Autodesk Inventor assembly. As you know by now, if a part is under constraint, you are able to click and drag to move it anywhere. Once we start adding constraints, then it starts to limit the ways in which it can move or rotate. When you're bringing a part in, you have the ability to rotate it before you place it. Let's say that I want to bring in another bolt. As I'm bringing it in, I can right-click my mouse and rotate around any of the three axes. This might be helpful to orient the part the way that you want so that you can grab the constraints. We can also use the Free Rotate tool here on the Assemble tab in the Position panel. I'll select Free Rotate and then the part, and then you can see that I can actually click and drag to rotate the part in place. Then I can just press Escape when I'm done. So that might help you when you are constraining. For example, if I wanted to place it underneath here and I wanted to be able to use my insert constraint rather than have to rotate my entire screen, I could rotate just the individual part, and that would make it easier to select the pieces that I want here. You can also move and rotate constrained components as well. So as you can see, every one of these components is fully constrained. I can't move them, but maybe I wanted to get inside this assembly and see some things. I can use the Free Move tool. With that, I can click and drag parts to move them out of the way. Then when I want them to come back together, I can just simply click the Update button in the Quick Access toolbar. The Free Rotate works the same way. If I select Free Rotate and select a part, you can see that I can actually rotate that in place as well. And then just simply update when I'm done to get that to go back to where its constraints originally had it. That concludes this look at moving and rotating components in Autodesk Inventor.